नमस्ते जी।
नमस्ते। अक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वतिनमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारम् प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरो वन्दे पार्वतीपरमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्यमहेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं पररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। अल्पाक्षरम् असन्दिग्धम्
अल्पाक्षरं संदिग्धं
असन्दिग्धं
सारवद्विश्वतोमुखम्
सारवद्विश्वतोमुखम्
अस्तोभम् अनवद्यं च
अस्तोभम्
अनवद्यं च
सूत्रं सूत्रविदो विदुः You all remember the meaning of this shloka? Alpaksharam. Alpa is a little. Minimum, few letters. Asandigdham should be free from any doubts. Free from any doubts. Asandigdham. Saravata should talk about only the essential thing. Vishvatomukam, multifaceted, applicable in many contexts. Astobham, there should not be any unnecessary words like praising or particle, no exclamatory. These are not allowed. Anavadyam should be free from any fault in terms of meaning as well as in terms of usage of the words, grammatically also free from grammatical errors as well as errors in terms of meaning. These are the six lakshanas, the characteristics of sutram. Viduhu is a kriyapadam here. We are not studied, don't worry. Viduhu, deno, uno, sutra vidaha, sutra miti viduhu. This is a meaning. You have seen the meaning in detail. You can refer to your notes. So this is a simple meaning of this shloka. Then, I won. Raluk.
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 Aung.
Aung.
I ouch.
I ouch.
Hayavarat.
Hayavarat.
Lun.
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 Nyamanganam.
Nyamanganam.
Jabhain. Ghadadash. Jabagadadash.
Jabagadadash.
Kapa chatata chatatau.
Kapa
chatata chatatau.
Kapai.
Kapai.
Shashasar.
Shashasar.
Hal.
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 Okay. What are the Val Pratyaharas? I mean, well, not Val Pratyahara. What are the contents of the Val Pratyahara? Val.
Starting with Vara, Hayavarat Vara.
Okay.
All the way up to Hal.
All the way up to Hal. In simple words, you can say,
All the consonants.
It can't be all the consonants. All the consonants.
Means except ya and va.
Good. Except ya only. Not ya and.
Sorry. Ya and ra, I said. But no.
Except the semi-vowel, ya. All the consonants are included in the Pratyahara Val. So this Mageshwar Sutra, you know, it's very important. When you memorize this sutra, you have to remember the itta letters of each sutra. You should know the itta letters of each sutra. You have to remember which sutra has got which itta letter. That's important to know. Ayun is there. Nakara is there. Yes. Lun also is there. Nakara there also. Nakara is there. Two places. Itta letter Nakara is there. Hayavarat Takara is there. Kapai Ekara is there. The itta letter, because when we form Pratyahara, how do we form? We form Pratyahara with a letter followed by the itta letter. Ach, when we say the A is the vowel. And the chakara is the itta letter. And the letters which are covered from the letter A up to the letter it, excluding it, all the letters are included. Therefore, the itta letters, which sutra has got which itta letter is important. So that is the end of the coverage of the Pratyahara. And starting from, of course, the first letter. It's important to know. So when we do further sandhi, we'll be saying the Pratyahara's usage. I hope all of you know by heart now. Then the next one. Next one is the knowledge of the place of pronunciation. It is very helpful all the way. We'll see. Akuga visarjaniyanam kantaha.
Akuha visarjaniyanam. Kantaha.
Ichu yashanam talu.
Ichu yashanam
talu.
Ruturashanam murdha.
Ruturashanam murdha.
Lutulasanam dantaha.
लुतुलसानादन्ताः
उपूपद्मानीयानाम् ओष्ठौ ज्ञमङ्गननाम् नासिका च एदैतोः कण्ठतालु ओदौतो गोकण्ठौष्टम् वकारस्य दन्तौष्टम् जिह्वामूलीयस्य जिह्वामूल्यम् नासिका अनुस्वारस्य अकारान्तः पुल्लिङ्गः रामशब्दः रामः रामो रामाः रामं रामो रामान् रामेण रामाभ्यां रामैः रामाय रामाभ्यां रामेभ्यः रामात रामाभ्यां रामेभ्यः रामस्य रामयोः रामाणाम् रामे रामयोः रामेषु
रामेषु
हे राम हे रामौ हे रामाः
हे राम
रामाः
सो एकवचनम् आफ् आल् द विभक्तिस् अगेन् रिमेम्बर् रामः रामं रामेण रामाय रामात् रामस्य रामे हे राम नौ यू कैन रिपीट आफ्टर् मी ऐ थिंक वी हैव सीन दिस बिफोर् इफ नॉट ओके हैव यू सीन दिस बिफोर्
यस मेंशन्ड दिस अर्लियर
ओके रामो राजमनिः सदा विजयते
रामो
राजमनिः सदा विजयते
रामं रमेशं भजे रामेणाभिगता निशाचर चमूः रामाय तस्मै नमः रामान्नास्ति परायणं परतरम् रामस्य दासोऽस्म्यहम् रामे चित्तलयः सदा भवतु मे भो राम मामुद्धर एकवचनम् ऑफ ऑल द विभक्तिस् यू विल सी हियर द फर्स्ट वन रामः इज देयर वेयर इज रामः वेयर इज रामः इज देयर
रामो दैट इज संधि
रामः संधि हैज हैपेंड व्हाट संधि यू आर नॉट सीन
विसर्ग
विसर्ग Have you seen Visarga Sandhi?
No, not yet. But it is Visarga Sandhi.
Okay. We are going to see. So, Ramaha becomes Ramo. So that is Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. Ramaha Rajamanihi Sada Vijayate. Vijayate is a Kriyapadam. Sada Vijayate. Always be victory to who? Rama. And who is Rajamanihi? Mani is gem. Raja is king. So he is a king of the Rajas. Gem. Is he gem of the Rajas? Who? Ramaha. So Ramaha, thus always be victory to Rama, Rajamanihi, Vijayate. And Ramam, what Vibhakti Ramam?
Dritiya.
Dritiya Vibhakti.
Then where is the Kriya Padam for that? Who is the subject? Dritiya Vibhakti, okay. Therefore, Dritiya Vibhakti means what should be that? What Karaka?
Karma Karaka.
Karma Karaka.
Must be Karma. Right, because Dvitiya Vibhakti, therefore, it could be Karma Karaka. So, Ramam, Rameshyam, who is a Karta?
Aham.
Ramesha.
Ramesha.
Aham. Aham is a Karta, not Ramesha.
Not?
Rameshyam is also is Dvitiya Vibhakti only. Ramesha, Ramesho, Ramesha, Aham. Where is Aham is there in the sentence? Aham is there?
No, as you, no. Because bhaje.
Bhaje is there, so.
What is bhaje?
Atmanepadi.
Atmanepadi.
We saw that, right, Umber?
Yeah.
Labate, labete, labante, labase, labete, labadve, labhe, labhavahe, labhamahe. You will see it again. Bhajate, bhajete, bhajante. Bhajase bhajethe bhajadve bhaje aham bhaje. I worship. Aham pujayami. Bhaja is namaskaromi, pujayami, namami. It is atmane paridhatu. Aham ramam bhaje. I salute Rama. Who is Ramesha? Who is Ramayaha Ishaha Ramesha? Who is the Lord of Rama? So, Aham Ramam Ramesham Bhaje. Ramam is Dvitiya Vibhakti, which is Karma, therefore Dvitiya Vibhakti Ekavachanam. And Ramesham also same. It is adjective. So, Aham Ramam Bhaje. And who is Rama? Is Ramesham Ramam Bhaje. So, Ramam is Dvitiya Vibhakti. That also has come. And the next part. Rame Na Bhikata. Sandhi has happened. You have to split. What Sandhi is that? You know the word. Tritiya Bhakti Ekavachana word is there.
Savarnatika Sandhi.
You split that, whatever the words you get.
Abhihata.
Abhigata, one word. Ramena.
Ramena Abhihata.
Ramena Abhigata. Nishachara Chamuhu is there. What is Nishachara Chamuhu? Nishachara Chamuhu is the army of the Rakshasas. Chamuhu is there. Have you seen Vadu Shabda Ukarantaha Strilingaha? I think we have not seen. But I have introduced only the first case, long back, if you remember. Vaduhu, Vadvau, Vadvaha, that is Ukarantaha Strilingaha Vadu Shabdaha. Vaduhu, Vadvau, Vadvaha, Vadum, Vadvau, Vaduhu. So Nishachara Chamuhu is the karma. I mean, it is karma, but here it is karmani prayoga, therefore it is one. Anyway, don't worry about it now. We will see. Ramena is Rama is the karta, but Rama is in Tritiya Vibhakti. Nishachara Chamuhu is the karma, but it is in Prathama Vibhakti here. Vaduhu Vadvau Vadvaha Vadum. Vaduhu, that Vaduhu is the Nishachara Chamuhu, Prathama Bhakti, that is. Ramena Abhigata, Ramena Abhigata, Nishachara Chamuhu. Nishachara Chamuhu is the karma, but it is in Prathama Bhakti. Chamuhu is Trilinga, therefore Abhigata. Don't worry about that, we will see. So here, it's Karmani Prayoga. Passive voice. Passive voice we have not yet learned. So don't do it. Passive voice, that will change. Karta will become Tritiya Vibhakti, Karma will become Prathama Vibhakti. We will see that. So Ramena is that the meaning of the sentence is Ramena Nishachara Chamogu Abhigatha. By Rama, the army of the Rakshasas were killed. So Ramena is there, Tritiya Bhakti is there. Then Rama Yatasmai Namaha. Namaha is there. Whenever you see Namaha, Tasmai will be there. I mean, Chaturthi will be there. Because Namaskara, you are offering Namaskara. So there must be person receiving the action of your salutation, right? Therefore it is Chaturthi will be there. Namaha is Avyaya. That will govern Chaturthi. We have seen this before. That is why in all the Namavali you will find Chaturthi Bhakti. Any Namavali you take. If it is Dalita Savasnama, you will find everything will be in Dalita Inamaha, Devya Inamaha, Shri Mata, Shri Matre Inamaha, Maharagya Inamaha, right? So Tasmai Inamaha, Ramaya Tasmai Inamaha, to Rama, my, to Rama salutation. Then the next line, Ramanasti Parayanam Parataram. What is Raman Nasti Sandhi again here? That's on what Sandhi we have not seen yet. We'll see. We will be seeing. Ramat plus Nasti. Ramat Parayanam Parataram Nasti. Panchami Ramat. Ramat is Panchami. Panchami is used also in the sense of comparison. Comparing the two. He is better than the other. Comparison is there. So therefore, Panchami is used. When there is comparison between the two things, then Panchami. Ramat, compared to Rama, Parayanam, the abode. Parayanam, the place of reach, abode. Parataram, the greatest, the ultimate, not there. Nothing other than Rama. Rama is the Parayanam. Ramayanam, Parayanam. Right? So, Panchami is the Ramat. Ramasya Dasosmyaham. What is Dasosmyaham? There Sandhi has happened. Two Sandhis are there. Three words are there. Between three words, two Sandhis have happened. You have to identify the words now.
Dasaha Asmi Aham.
Dasaha. Dasaha becomes
Dasosmi.
Dasaha become Daso. We don't know. We don't know. Daso plus Asmi. What happens to that? That Sandhi we know. Daso plus Asmi.
Dasosmi. Purva Rupa.
Very good. Daso is Ing. The letter Ing is there. So you have to recollect what we have studied. We have studied only seven rules, I think. Seven.
Yeah. Six.
Six plus the optional rule, one rule will be there. Therefore, seven. Oh. Adanta Yakara is there. That is also there. So, Daso, O is there. O is Ing letter. Padanta Ing. Daso is ending with A.
O.
I mean, O. Padanta Ing, when followed by the another padam beginning with A. Then Purva Parayogasthane Purva Deshaka Bhavati. In the place of Purva as well as in the Para, Purva will be the replacement. Therefore, Dasosmi. Now, Dasosmi. Asmi plus Aham.
Yan Sandhi.
Yan Sandhi.
Asmi Aham.
So, Aham, Ramasya Dasaha. I am the servant of Rama. So, Ramasya is what Karaka?
It's not a karaka.
Good. This. The answer should be not a karaka. Yes.
Sambandha.
Sambandha. It's a connection, relation. Das, between what and what the relation is?
Sambandha. between Rama, Rama and Dasa.
Very good. Between Dasa and Rama, Sambandha. Ramasya Dasaha. Yes. And Dasa is myself. Aham Dasa asmi. Whose Dasa am I? Ramasya.
Ramasya Dasa.
Then the next one. Rame Chittalaya Sada Bhotume. Rame is what, Vibhakti? Saptami.
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 Chitta Layaha. Layaha is resolution. Resolution of my chitta, my mind. Be there always in Rama Bhavatu Me. Bhavatu is lot. We just started, but after that, we didn't do that. We'll do it later. Bhavatu Me. What is Me? What is Me there?
It is.
You have to see as mind. Much.
As much.
Yeah, what vibhakti is that?
Mahyam me.
Mama me.
Mama me. Mama chitta layaha.
Mama. Okay.
Right. My resolution of the chinta be there always in Rama. Me is in two places. Mahyam me. Mama me. Right?
Yes.
Rama is 7-1. Bho Rama Mamuddara. Here, what is Rama?
Sambodhana.
Hey Rama or Bho Rama, all these are Sambodhana. Mam, what is Mam? Uddhara. What is Mam?
Dvitiya Vibhakti.
Mam is Asmat Shabda, Dvitiya Vibhakti. It is the object. Hey Rama, Mam, Uddhara. Who is a Karta here?
Rama.
Rama.
Rama is a karta. You're asking Rama, hey Rama, Mam Uddhara, you lift me up. Go Rama, Mam Uddhara. So all the vachanams, of all the vibhaktis are given in this shloka, the beautiful shloka. So Rama Shabda is presented here. So nice to chant. So we'll chant this. Then.
Sharanji, one doubt, sorry.
Yeah.
Rajamanihi means gem among the kings.
Mm.
Suppose you want to talk about king among the gems. What is the word you will use?
King among the?
Among the gems. Like okay. Raja Vidya, it comes, no? King among all the Vidyas.
Mm-hmm.
There we say Raja Vidya is king among the Vidyas. Here we don't say Rajamanihi is king among the gems. We say gem among the kings.
Rajanam Manihi, Rajamanihi. If it is the other way, Mani should come first and Raja should go late next time.
Okay.
Mani Rat.
Mani Raja or something like that.
Something like that, yes. Depending on what qualifies.
Okay.
We will see that is compound. Okay. Yeah, it's compound word.
Okay. Thanks.
Now, we have seen Rama Shabda. I don't know whether I told it before. I will tell you the order. Okay, let me ask. Do you all know all the Shabdas, what we have learned so far? The Shabdas are important because I assume that you know Shabdas and then proceed further. Do you know all the Shabdas? And just be frank, okay? Kettle, you know? No. Otherwise,
not by heart. No.
Hmm?
No.
Okay, I will help you in seeing the similarity and at least you can, you know, see this, connect these Shabdas and remember the order. Rama Shabda, you know, right? Once you know Rama Shabda, then the next Shabda, you can take Tad Shabda. You just listen. Dakarantaha, Pullingaha, Tad Shabdaha. Tad means, you know, that. Sahatavate, that you have to remember. We have seen Sahatavate in the beginning. So we have used Saha Taute. Ramaha Ramo Ramaha. There is no connection. It's different, totally different. Now, Dvitiya Vibhakti, you take Ramam Ramo Ramana. You see now the connection, same similarity. Tam Tautan. Is there similarity? Ramam Ramo Ramana. Am Au An is there, right? That's a connection, similarity. tam tau tan. Then Ramena Rama Abhyam Ramaihi. Tenata Abhyam Taihi. You can just remember the same way as Rama, right? Then Chaturthi. Ramaya is there. Yat Tasmai. That you need to remember. Tasmai Chaturthi Bhakti Ekavachanam is different from Rama Shabda. And Dvivachanam. Rama Abhyam. Yartabhyam. Ramebhyaha. Tebhyaha. So number one, you have to remember Chaturthi Ekavachanam. And Ramat. Yartasmat. That also same. Tasmat. Chaturthi, Panchami, Shashti, you will see Tas, Tas, Tas. Tasmai, Tasmat, Tasya. So Tasmat. Ramat. Ramabhyam, Ramebhyaha, Tabhyam, Tebhyaha. Ramasya, Tasya. Ramayohu, Tayohu. Ramanam, Tesham. That you need to remember. Shashti, Bhakti, Bhagavachanam, you have to remember. Tesham. Tas, then Rame, Ya Tasmin. Ramayohu, Tayohu. Rameshu, Teshu. So Tasmin, you have to remember. Really speaking, you need to remember only 4-5 words of that Shabda. If you know Rama Shabda, you know that Shabda. Yes or no? Right?
Yes. Yes.
So, Tasmai, Tasmat, Tasya, Tesham, Tasmin. 5 words you need to know. Because we know Sagata Ute. So, we don't have to repeat that. Sagata Ute we have used in the beginning many times. Right? So, if you know that Shabda, you will see what all the other shabdas you can easily know. So first starting point is Rama Shabda, then Tat Shabda. Okay. Let us do it. Dakarantaha Pullingaha Tad Shabdaha.
Dakarantaha
Pullingaha
Shabdaha.
Sahatavute.
Sahatavute.
Tam Tautana. Tasmin tayoho teshu.
Tasmin tayoho teshu.
Only 4-5 words, I think, you need to know. So you know the Tat Shabda. Now, assume that you know Tat Shabda. Now, then the next one. E Tat Shabda, same as Tat Shabda. Only thing is, A is there at the beginning. Other than that, there is no difference. You see, Sahataute, here Eshaha, one difference is that Eshaha, that is only one different form. Tau Eshaha, Eto, Ete. Taute, A is added. Then Etam, Etam, Tam, Tam Tautan, in Tat Shabda. Here Etam, Eto, Etan. Enam, Eno, Enan, another form is that, even if you don't remember, doesn't matter. When the word comes, you need to know what it is. Then tenatabhyam taihi, etenatabhyam, etaihi, tasmaitabhyam. So if you know tachabda, the shabda is, you know, you don't have to do any special effort to memorize this. Tachabda, you know, you just add A before that. So the shabda is known, right? So now you know how many shabdas you know. 3 shabdas at a stretch, you know it. So let us not chant this, because it's same as tachabda. So we'll skip this. Now, Kim Shabda. You know Tat Shabda. Now you see, this is Kim Shabda. Tat Shabda is Sahataute. Here it is Kaha Kauke. We are talking only about Pullinga. Okay. Then Tam Tautan, Kam Kaukan. Same as the Tat Shabda. Right? So if you know Tat Shabda, Kim Shabda is as well known. Right? So let us do this. Makarantaha, Pullingaha, Kim Shabdaha.
मकारान्तः
पुल्लिङ्गः किं शब्दः
कः
कौके
कं कौकान् केन काव्यां कैः कस्मै काव्यां केभ्यः कस्मात् काव्यां केभ्यः कस्य कयोः केषाम् कस्मिन् कयोः केषु So tat shabda, you know kim shabda. So remember this order. Rama shabda first, then tat shabda. Tat shabda you know, then etat shabda you know. Then kim shabda. It is in the same format as tat shabda. Right? Then the next one. If you know tat shabda, then you know yat shabda also. Same as that form only. Format is same. So you remember in this order. Try to remember the shabdas in this order. You will find it easy. Easy to remember. Dakarantaha pullingaha yad shabdaha.
Dakarantaha pullingaha yad shabdaha.
Yaha yauye. You see, Sahataute, Kakauke, Yaka Yauye. Same. Yam Yauyan.
Yam Yauyan.
Yena Yabyam Yehi.
Yena
Yabyam Yehi.
Yasme Yabyam Yebyaha.
Yasme
Yabyam Yebyaha.
Yasmat Yabyam Yebyaha. Starting from the Pullinga Shabda, Rama Shabda, up to this. Then Ari Shabda, Guru Shabda, they are different. They are different. Let us do this. Hari. Ikarantaha pullingaha hari shabdaha.
Ikarantaha
pullingaha
hari shabdaha.
Harihi hari harayaha.
Hari
hari harayaha.
Harim hari harin.
Harim
Hari 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 Hari
Hari
Hari
Hari Hari Hari Hari Hari
Hari
Hari
Hari Hari Hari Hari Hari
Hari
Hari
Hari Hari Haryoho Harinam.
Hare
Hare
Haryoho
Harinam.
Haro Haryoho Harishu.
Haro Haryoho
Harishu.
Harishu.
He Hare, He Hari, He Harayaha.
He
Hare, He Hari, He Harayaha.
This shabda has no connection. Connection with the Rama Shabda. Connection only you can say Bhyam, Bhyam, Bhyam is there. And Bhi, Bhyaha. Those are the things common. Other than that, you have to remember the Shabda. If you know this Shabda, Hari Shabda, you can remember another Shabda also. Another Shabda which is an exception. How do you decline the Shabda Pati? Pati Shabda. You know, Pati. Pati meaning master or husband. That is an Pati is Ikarantaha. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Pati Shabdaha. That is another important Shabda, Pati. important shabda, you will find the shabda manjari. I have not included here in our list because I thought I will do it later. But now time has come to do it. Pati. Now, Hari Shabda, you keep with you. And you see the similarity now. Pati is Pullinga. Pati is Pullinga. But it is not declined like Hari. But there are a lot of similarities. Lot of similarities. Only at 4 or 5 places, the words are different. Otherwise, same as Hari. Let us see. I'm sharing the PDF file. You can see. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Pati Shabdaha. Hari Hari Harayaha. Same way. Patihi Pati Patayaha.
Patihi Pati Patayaha.
So Pratama Bhakti, no difference. Then Dvitiya Bhakti. Patim Pati Patina.
Patim Pati.
Is that difference from Hari Shabda?
No.
Same. Now, Tritiya, you see. Patya, Patibhyam, Patibihi.
Patibhihi.
Now, you see the difference?
Harinash.
Harina, it is. Here, Patya. So, the difference is there only. Tritiya, Vibhakti. It is not Patina. It is Patya.
Yeah.
So, 3-1, you can note. One word, Patya. Then, Chaturthi. Patye, Patibhyam, Patibhyaha.
Patye,
Patibhyam,
Patibhyaha.
Patibhyaha.
Is it same as Hari?
No.
What's the difference?
Patye.
Haraye.
It is Haraye. It is Haraye, not Hariye. So, here Patye is there. Therefore, difference is there. Not Patye. It is Patye. So, Chaturthi Bhakti, Ekavachanam. So, Tritiya, Ekavachanam, Chaturthi, Ekavachanam. Then, Panchami. Patyuhu, Patibhyam, Patibhyaha.
Patyuhu,
Patibhyam, Patibhyaha.
Is it same as Hari?
No.
In the Hari, it was Hare.
Here,
Patyuhu. So, Patyuhu, you have to remember. Panchami Ekavachanam, difference is there. Then, the next one, Shashti. Patyuhu, Patyoho, Patinam.
Patyuhu, Patyoho,
Patinam.
Here also, Shashti Vibhakti, different. Arehe, Aribhya. Aryoho, Harinam, right? Here, Patyuhu is there. So, Shashti Vibhakti, Ekavachanam, also different. Then, Saptami, Saptami you can see. Patyau, Patyoho, Patishu.
Online class.
Patyau, Patyoho, Patishu.
Swarindaji, please don't talk with your mic in mute to others. You can with your mic in unmute condition. Mute your mic. You can have conversation. Patyau, Patyoho, Patishu. Patyau is there. That's a, you can see there's a mistake. I mean, not mistake, it's a printing. It should be Patyau.
Patyau.
Okay. You can mark it in your book. Patyau, Patyoho, Patishu. Harau, Haryoho, Harishu. In Harishabda. Here, Patyau, Patyoho, Patishu. Difference is there. So, Saptami, Ekavachanam, there is a difference. So these are the places. And one more is there, which is in Sambodhana. Other than this, same as Harishabda. Sambodhana, you see. He Pate, He Pati, He Patayaha.
He Pate, He Pati, He Patayaha.
He Hari, He Hari. That's what He Hari, right? He Hari or He Hari?
He Hari.
He Hari. There is no difference. There also there is no difference. He Hari, He Hari, He Hari. So, therefore, Tritiya Ekavachana, only at 4 places. 3-1, 4-1, 5-1, so on. These are the places where it is, where it differs from the Hari Shabda. Otherwise, it is same. Right? So, you know Pati Shabda also now. If you know Hari Shabda, then Patishabda is as noun. And this Pati.
Charanji.
Charan.
Yeah.
How do you differentiate which one should be used?
How do you differentiate? What does it mean?
I mean, when you see a pullinga which is ending with a ikaranta, how do you know if you have to use Harishabda or Patishabda? You know, to
Patishabda is an exception to Harishabda. I'm not saying two possibilities are there. No.
Okay.
Patishabda is an exception to Harishabda. Harishabda is the format. The general format is Harishabda. All pullinga shabda will be declined like Harishabda. Pati Shabda is different. That is what I am telling. And the Pati as a word, separately it is there. It is different from Harishabda. Whereas the Pati is part of the compound word like Ganapati, Raghupati, Sabhapati. Right? It's a compound.
Okay.
If it is part of the compound, then it is declined like Harishabda. No difference. Not like Pati. Oh. Remember this. Important.
Okay.
If it is Ganapati, then Harishabda. Ganapataye Namaha, we say. Right?
Okay.
Namo Vrata Patage, Namo Ganapataye, Namah Pramata Patage, Namaste Yastu Lambodaraya. Why Vrata Patage, Ganapataye? Ganapataye is supposed to be declining like Patishabda. It should be Ganapatye. Chaturthi Bhakti Ekavachana. Not Pataye. But in the mantra it is Pataye. So therefore Haraye. So all the the words like Ganapati and Raghupati, when Pati is part of the compound, then it is declined like Harishabda. When Pati alone is there, different. Pati is always exception, right?
Okay.
Husband always exception. Therefore, differentiations are different. Then,
Shailji, yes. When you say the Hare Rama, it's a Hare Rama, Hare. So Hare is the Sambodhana there? Hare Rama or Rama? Hare Rama.
Rama is Sambodhana. Hare, Hare Rama.
Rama.
Yeah. Okay. Not Rama, there is no Rama. Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. Hare is also another article. So, Sambodhana.
Okay.
Rama, Borama, Hare Rama.
Hare Rama. Oh, so it is a
Sambodhana only.
It is not the thing for Hari. It's not Hari he being
No connection with Hari. Okay. Where is Hare? Hey, Hare, you are saying?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Brahadaranyaka Upanishad, there is a lot of Hare.
That is where? That is different. That array is different. This array is different. That is a. This is ha.
Array. Oh, that is array.
Okay. This is a vowel. That is a consonant. Anyway, that is array is Sambodhana. Hey Rama.
Okay.
If it's hey Hare, hey, then what is that? Hey Hari, hey Rama. It should be Sambodhana.
Yeah.
It should be Sambodhana. Array is Sambodhana.
Okay, Sharanji.
Because Krishna is there, then why should we use Hari again? Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hey Hare, Hey Krishna.
Okay, Sharanji.
So Hare Krishna is Sambodhana there. Sambodhana. So we have to take the mantra.
I think in Hindi, colloquial Hindi, they use Hare, right?
Hare.
This is Sanskritam. Yeah. We are talking about Sanskritam.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying. Probably they used it from there.
Mantra cannot be like that. If it is a Shabara mantra, then possible. Okay, then now Harishabda is over. The next Shabda. Harishabda, you know, then Patishabda. We are not going to spend the whole class for Shabda. With Guru Shabda, we will stop the Shabda part. But you can see the similarity and remember the Shabdas in that order. Right? So, some exceptions that we have to memorize. We have to know it. Then Guru, Ukarantaha, Pullingaha, Guru Shabdaha.
Ukarantaha Pullingaha
Guru Shabdaha
Guru Guru Guravaha
Guru
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 Guravaha
Gurum Guru Guruna
Guru
Guru
Guruna Gurubhyam Gurudihi.
Guruna
Gurubhyam Gurudihi.
Between Hari and Guru, you can see the similarity. Hari is Ikaranta. Harihi, Hari is there. Dvivachanam is Dirga. Hari, your Guru. And Harayaha, your Guravaha. Here you can see, Hari is what? E is there, right? Guru is U. Therefore, U is there, therefore Vaha. You can see, Va, U, in the place of U, Va has come. Right? Guru becomes Guravaha. Prathama Vibhakti Bhagavachanam Guravaha. In the place of U, Va has come. In the place of E, what should come?
Yeah.
You can see the N's and the connection. It's nothing to do with the N. You can see the connection of the N letters. Hari being E, therefore Yaha. So wherever that E replacement take place, it will be Yakara will be there. And similarly here, the U replacement take place, Vakara will be there. Therefore, Haraye, Gurave, you can see, right? Now you can remember. Hari is there, therefore E is replaced by Ya, and U is replaced by Va. Therefore, Guravaha, Harayaha. In this way, you can remember, if it is easy for you. Okay. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then, Harim, Hari, Arina, Gurum, Guru, Gurun. Same, no difference, same as Hari. So, Hari Shabda, you know. Then Guru Shabda, you can guess and you can do. Then Harina is there, Guruna is there. Haribhyam, Gurubhyam. Haribhihi, Gurubhihi. Then Chaturthi, Haraye, here you see Gurave. Who is replaced by Va? Va, Ve is there, Gurave. Gurave, Gurubhyam, Gurubhyaha.
Gurave,
Gurubhyam, Gurubhyaha.
Then Guruho, there what was the word? Hare. So A is there. E is replaced by A. You can see the connection. E is Talu. A is Kanta Talu. U is Oshta in Guru. And O is what is O?
Kanta Oshta.
Kanta Oshta. There E is replaced by a conjunct consonant A. Therefore, here U must be replaced by a conjunct consonant O.
O.
By the conjunct consonant, that is Yang. Yang conjunct consonant. A-O. Only two letters are there. Yang. There, Hare, A is, that E is replaced by A. A of Yang. Here, U is there, U is replaced by O of Yang. That is a connection. You can remember like this. It will be easy. Guruho, Gurubhyam, Gurubhyaha.
Guruho, Gurubhyam, Gurubhyaha.
Guruho, Guruvoho, Gurunam.
Guruho,
Guruvoho,
Gurunam.
Then, Saptami is Au only. Whether it is Hari or Guru. Harau, here Gurau. Gurau, Gurvoho, Gurushu.
Gurau,
Gurvoho,
Gurushu.
He Guru, he Guru, he Guravaha.
He Guru,
he Guru,
he Guravaha.
He Hare, he is there. Here, O is there. Okay. So we have spent more than 40 minutes for this. But you can remember now, next class, all the Pullinga Shabda. Yes?
Yes, Sharanji.
Yes, Sharanji.
Yes, Sharanji.
So, Pullinga Shabda, in this way, you can remember, see the connection and remember the Shabdas. Do you see the connection and appreciate the order? This is how yes. I taught to the people in the course here.
Yes, Sharanji.
They found it easy. So,
yeah, it's very useful.
The same thing, same way we can do for Strilinga also. We'll do it in the next class. Now, let us continue with what we discussed in the last class. You can just recollect this Sakara. The Sakara is important. Okay. Sakara is important. But as a poor Sakara doesn't get that much recognition. It is Sakara which undergoes changes, a lot of changes. It is the Janna Karanam for Visarga. We say Visarga Sandhi also Sandhi. But what is Visarga Sandhi? Visarga, even for Visarga to come, Sakara is a cause. We say Repa and all. But for Repa also, Visarga, the Sakara is the cause. Okay. The Sakara and all you will find as part of the Pratyaya. The Pratyaya, you just have some, you know, a general knowledge of what Pratyaya. In detail, it's not required now. When we study Sutra, then we may see. Pratyas, you will find Sakara will, many Sakara, in many Pratyas, you will find Sakara will be there. And in the Shabda, when we decline the Shabda, that all the Vibhaktis and Vachanam, how do you get? By adding the Pratyas, right? And those Pratyas, you know, the collection of those Pratyas are called Sup. We have learned that, Sup Pratyaya. Collection of all the Pratyas, you know, corresponding to all the Vibhaktis and the Vachan, collectively called Sup. So in the Pratyaya, you will find Sakara will be there. That is why you get Ramaha. How you get Ramaha? It is born of that Sakara. Because Sakara is there in the Pratyaya, therefore you get Ramaha. Ramu, that Sakara is not there. Ramaha, Sakara is there. Right? Ramebhyaha. Sakara is there. Ramaihi. So many places you will find Sakara. Even in Kriyapadam also you will find. Patami, Patavaha, Patamaha. Patamaha, Patamaha. Patavaha, Maha. So Sakara must be there before Visarga was. Before Visarga came, Sakara was there. So many places you will find Sakara. Wherever Visarga is there, you can guess the previous form must be Sakara. You can guess. Okay. So now this Sakara, which is at the end of a Padam. You know what a Padam is. Padam is a technical word. Padam is a technical word. It could be a Nama Padam or Kriya Padam. So this Sakara at the end of the Padam, we call Padanta Sakara. Padanta Sakara will become Repa. That's the rule. That is rule number one. We saw in the last class, right? Padanta Sakara will become Repa. So you can see here, and the last class I gave this example. Rama is if Shabda, Pratipadikam. To the Shabda Rama, we are adding the Pratyaya Sakara. Pratyaya Sakara corresponding to Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam. We don't know what this Pratyaya is. Doesn't matter. I'm just giving the example. The Pratyaya corresponding to Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam is Sakara only. Sakara. The Pratyaya. In the last class, I would have said soon. I gave additional information. If you can remember, it is good. Otherwise, you can remember Sakara. That is enough now. No problem. So Rama plus Sakara becomes Ramas. What is Ramas? Ramas is a Padam. And what is Sakara? Padanta Sakara. Now the rule is Padanta Sakara will be replaced by Repa. So becomes Ramar. Correct? Understand?
Yes, Sharanji.
So Ramar. Now this is rule number. Applying the rule number one, we get Ramar. Similarly, Harir, similarly, Gurur, similarly, Patamar, and all. Now, what happens? Now, Repa is there. Repa is at the end of the Padam, right? Ramar is there. Harir is there. Gurur is there. Repa now is at the end of the Padam. Now, rule number two. You can write rule number two. Repa is Padanta Repa. Padanta Repa. Padanta Repa, what will happen? Padanta Repa will be replaced by Visarga. Now Visarga Jananam has happened. Padanta Repa will become Visarga. So Sakara to Repa, Repa to Visarga. This is how Visarga is born. So, Ramas we saw. That is Ramas here. We saw Ramar. Now Ramar has come from Ramas. Now what happens? This Ramar will become Ramaha. So Padantarepa becomes Visarga Ramaha. This is rule number 2. You can say 2A. Okay. Padantarepa becomes Visarga. Then 2B rule number. That is Padantarepa is there. Okay. Padantarepa. When it is followed by a kar letter. What is a kar? What are the letters?
Hard consonants.
In the kar, hard consonants.
Hard consonants.
What are the letters? How will you say them? Kapa cha tha tha cha tha. There we have to stop. That is first letter, second letter of all the classes. Right? And all the sibilants except ha. So it will be 13 letters totally. Right? These are the kar letters. If any kar letter follows, when does the kar letter follow? In a sentence, a padam is followed by another padam. Ramaha chalati. Right? Ramaha chalati. What will happen now? Ramar is there. Ramar is one padam, followed by another padam chalati. And Ramar repa is here. Repa is at the end of the padam. Yes. If it is at the end of the padam, it becomes Ramaha. Or if it is followed by a kar letter, chakara is a kar letter or not? Sir?
Yes.
Therefore, applying any of the condition, Ramar will become Ramaha. Applying any of the condition. Two conditions are fulfilled. But any one is enough. Okay. Not two conditions. Two conditions. At two different conditions, this will happen. If Repa is at the end of the Padam, or Repa when followed by Kar, then Repa will become Visarga. This is a rule. So here, Ramar fulfills both conditions. So well, good. So Ramar become Ramaha Chalati. Up to this we saw in the last class. Clear?
Yes, Sharanji.
Any doubt in this? You can ask. Anybody can ask if any doubt is there. From this, we are going to start. Anybody having any doubt, you can ask. You can please unmute your mic and ask if any doubt is there. Otherwise, I will assume you know. Okay. Then, now comes the next rule. That is rule number 3. Listen, now Visarga is born. Okay, let me ask you again. Repeat the same thing. I will ask you, you can repeat. Padanta Sakara becomes what?
Padanta Repa.
Repa.
Let other person, I want other person also to respond. Padanta Sakara becomes?
Repa.
And Padanta Repa, what will happen?
Visarga.
And Repa when followed by Kar letter, what will happen?
Visarga.
Repa when followed by Kar, when I say, it need not be a Padanta Repa. Clear? Repa at the end of a Padam will become Visarga. That is rule. Repa when followed by a kar, when I say, it need not be a padanta repa. It could be any repa. Okay. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, two different conditions. I give example where the repa happens to be at the end of the padam and also followed by a kar. There could be cases where repa is followed by a kar letter and repa need not be at the end of the padam. Then also, visarga will be the replacement. Clear? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now Visarga is born. Now what will happen to Visarga? the previous example we saw Ramaha Chalati Visa, right? Ramaha Chalati, Rama goes. Now Visarga is there. Visarga followed by what letter?
Kar letter.
Kar letter.
Cha is there. Cha is a kar letter. Now the Visarga will not keep quiet. It will further change. That is the next rule. You see the sequence. What will happen when Visarga followed by kar letter? The rule is, when Visarga is followed by kar letter, it will become Sakara again. You see, from Sakara, Visarga came, right? When Sakara, Visarga came. Again, Visarga becomes Sakara. Punarapi Maranam, Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Janane, Jatere Shayanam. Suti Suti Adhyanam. Right? So now see, Visarga when followed by kar letter becomes Sakara. Now taking the same example. Other examples are given. You forget about that. Example what I type today that you can see and remember. Ramaha Chalati Visa. Yes. Now Ramaha is there. Followed by kar letter is there. Therefore Visarga will become Ramas Chalati. Then don't apply again. Patanta Sakara is there. Therefore, I will apply. You go round, round that route. Ramas Chalati. So here, after this, we have to do something. What we'll do, we'll see. We'll see one by one. Because kar letter is there. How many letters are there in kar? I said 13 letters.
13
are there.
Letters.
First class, first letter of all the classes. Second letter of all the classes. And the three sibilants. We will see one by one, then you will see the changes happening to Visarga. Now let us take the Shar letter. Okay, and because for Shar we will finish it off first. Shar, what is Shar? What is Shar?
Shar.
Remember, that's why Pratyaharas are important. The three sibilants, the three. What are those three sibilants? Shasha. What are the properties of that letters? That is why they are together. Okay. See, people with like-minded are together. Similarly, letters with similar properties are put together by Maheshwara. Put together by Panini Maharshi in the form of Maheshwara Sutra. It is revealed by Bhagavan. Amazing. It's very amazing. What are the similarities between the three sibilants?
Dental.
Not dental. All are dental? No? Talu, Ruttu Rashana, Murda, Lutulasana. They are not same, right? Not same. Place of pronunciations are different. Then one similarity is there. Any similarities are there, but you can say one.
They are hard consonants.
Very good. They are hard consonants. That's a similarity, right? That is why it is kar. See, in the, and we are talking about kar. Kar is hard consonant. What about shar? It is hard consonant.
Okay. Right?
Ha is not included. Why? Ha.
It's a soft consonant.
Soft consonant.
That is why it is at the beginning itself. I have read there as a part of the soft consonant in the Maheshwara Sutra, it is there. And as part of the sibilant, again it is repeated at the 14th Sutra, Hal. Here. Why Ha is there in two places? Because it is a soft consonant and also happened to be the sibilant. Therefore, along with the sibilant, it is there. Shashasar Hal Iti. And also in, as part of the 5th Sutra, however, it is there at two places. That is the reason why Ha is there at two places. Okay. Not without any reason. Because Ha has got both the properties. Therefore, in both places, it has to be there. It has to play the role of the husband as well as son-in-law. Therefore, both places are there. Right? Now, Shar is there. Shar is a sibilant. Now, the rule says, the next rule, Rule number four. When Visarga is, now Visarga is born, okay. Visarga is born. When Visarga is followed by Shar letter, What did we say? If it is followed by a kar letter, we say sakara will be the replacement. Sakara. Now, if and shar being a part of kar, either sakara will remain, either sakara will be replaced by, that visarga will be replaced by sakara, or visarga will remain as it is. Two possibilities are given. What did we say when it is followed by a kar letter? Visarga must be replaced by sakara. And when it is followed by shar, what we say? That visarga can remain as visarga also, we say. Also, it means what? Sakara can be there. Visarga also can be there. No problem. I mean, any possibility. Two possibilities are there. Any one. Either visarga can be replaced by sakara, or visarga will remain as it is. Clear? Yes?
Yes, Sharanji.
Yeah.
See, we said visarga followed by a kar letter, visarga must be replaced by sakara. That is the rule, rule number three. Here, rule number three, I'm highlighting, I'm showing that. Now, this rule says, when it is followed by a shar, which is a part of kar, visarga can be replaced by sakara, or let visarga remain as it is. No problem. So, therefore, we will have two forms. That is why, in many chanting, you will find, even now we chanted, Ramo Rajamanihi Sadha Vijayate. Why Rajamanihi? You take that, Rajamanihi. Remember the shloka just now we chanted? Rajamanihi, then Sada comes. Rajamanihi plus Sada. What happened? We chanted now. Rajamanihi plus Sada becomes Rajamanihi Sada. Nothing happens. Visarga remains as it is. This is one possibility. But how did we chant? Ramo Rajamanis Sada Vijayate. Right? What did we do? Rajamanihi Sada. Is there? When we chanted, we said Rajamanis Sadha, right? This is how we chanted. In many chanting also we do. Yes? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, Ramo Rajamanis Sadha Vijayate. In many places, in other shlokas also you will find. So, Rajaman, that is...
Yogino.
Sorry?
Guru Stotra, Pashyantiyam, Pashyantinam Yogino. Sometimes we say Yoginaha.
No, that is different. When it is followed by kar letter, we are talking. Visarga followed by kar letter. Yes, Sada is a sakara is a kar letter. Visarga Rajamanihi, Visarga is there, followed by a kar letter. What happens? Visarga will remain as it is, or Visarga will be replaced by sakara. So, two possibilities. In printing, generally you will find this is a form you will find. This will be like this in Gita and other books you will find. When Visarga is followed by Shar letter, they will give like this. But when we chant Rajamanis Sada Vijayate. You can say Rajamanihi Sada Vijayate, nothing wrong. But we say Rajamanis because it fits well when we chant. Therefore, Visarga replaced by Sakara. Is this clear? Sure. So, two forms are there. Another example we will take. Now, let me take from here. Ramaha plus Shete is there. Ramaha plus Shete. What is Shete? Shete means sleeps. Okay, Rama sleeps. Shete is sleeps. Who sleeps? Ramaha. Now, applying the rule, Visarga can remain Visarga. Visarga can remain Visarga. So, applying the rule, you get Ramaha plus Shete is Ramaha Shete. Nothing happens. Then, applying the other possibility. Ramaha plus Shete will become what?
Ramas Shete.
Ramas Shete. Now, it doesn't stop here because two sibilants are there. Two sibilants, when they come together, some change happens. And particularly when Sakara is there. Sakara, I'm just using the word weaker. There's nothing called weak or strong. When Sakara is there, assuming that is why it is, I'm using the word weaker, because it is going to change now. Okay. It is going to change. Listen, when Sakara is in contact. What does it mean, contact? It means when Sakara is preceded by or followed by. Preceded also or followed by. Followed by Shakara, then Sakara must be replaced by the corresponding by the sibilant. Sakara must be replaced by that sibilant. Now, what happens? Therefore, Ramas becomes Ramash. Ramas becomes Ramash. And Ramash Shete becomes Ramash Shete. Right? Sakara should be replaced by the following Shakara. When Sakara is in contact with Shakara, Sakara will be replaced by Shakara, Shete. This we call the Shchutva Sandhi, and we will see that later. But remember this. Now, this is optional form. Ramash Shete. Clear? It becomes Ramash Shete. Sakara is what? It's a hard consonant. And Sha is also odd consonant. So, and it happens to be a sibilant. Therefore, Sakara must be replaced by a Shakara, by the other sibilant. And the other sibilant is what follows. Shakara follows. Therefore, Sakara is replaced by Shakara. Ramashete. Okay. So, among the kar letter, now you see, among the shar letter, when followed by sa, we have seen. When followed by sha, we have seen. Then one kar letter is left out. What is that?
Sha.
Murganeshakara is.
Murganeshakara.
Let us see that. Ramaha. I'm just taking an example. This typing is a problem. Yeah. Ramaha plus Shashtaha. Now, Visarga is there, followed by Murdhanya Shakara. Applying the rule will remain as it is. Nothing will happen. Ramaha Shashtaha. Ramaha Shashtaha. Other possibility is Ramaha plus Shashtaha, what will happen? The Visarga will be replaced by Sakara. First rule. The first thing is Visarga replaced by Sakara. Then Shashtaha. Now the Sakara will not remain. It will change further. It will be replaced by the sibilant. It will be replaced by the sibilant. What are the sibilants? Sakara is a hard consonant. What are the hard sibilants? Sha, sha, sa. Three are there. Which will be the best replacement? That which follows will replace it. Simple. Shakara follows. Therefore, the same Shakara will come. Same form will come and sit in the place of Shakara. Therefore, you will have Ramash. You will have Ramashashtaha. You will have this form. Clear? Is this Sandhi clear? So now you remember this sequence. First is Padanta Sakara becomes Repa, and Padanta Repa becomes Visarga, and Repa when followed by Kar letter also will become Visarga. And now that Visarga when followed by Kar will be undergoing a lot of changes. And among the Kar letter, we are talking about Shar only. Shar is Sha, Sha, Sa. What will happen when it followed by a Shar letter? Visarga optionally replaced by Sakara. It means Sakara will be the replacement or Visarga will remain as it is. Then if it is Sakara, the Kar letter follows. Then we have saw the examples. Rajamanigi Sada or Rajamani Sada. Two possibilities are there. And when followed by a Shakara, Talavi Shakara, then Ramaka Shete, example. Ramaka Shete, Visarga replaced by Visarga. That is, Visarga doesn't undergo any change. It remains as it is. Visarga is not replaced by Sakara. That is one. If it is replaced by Sakara, what will happen? Then Sakara will undergo further change. The Sakara will be replaced by another sibilant, the following sibilant. Right? Shete. If it is followed by a Murdanya, the Murdanya will be the replacement. These are the things we have seen today. What about the other Kar letters? Only Shar we have seen. Another 10 letters are there. First letter of all the classes, second letter of all the classes. We will see. We will see. One by one, slowly. Okay. Any doubt in this?
No, Sharanji.
No, Sharanji.
Is it difficult to follow?
No, Sharanji.
It's easy and clear.
Okay. Please remember the Shabdas. Shabdas are very important. So next class we will see the Srilinga Shabda. And we have to, you know, expand our Shabda vocabulary, Shabda bank. Shabda, we have to know a lot of Shabdas. We will add one by one. In fact, I added Denu, Mati and all. We should add some more. Okay. So we'll stop here. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Please have a scribbling pad and note the rules in the order. And later we will see, I'll present the same rules in a particular order. You'll see. So the rules are important. You follow in the same order. And remember the sequence. Right? Dhanyavada. Thank you.
Dhanyavada
Sharanji.
Dhanyavada Sharanji.
धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद